Hello everyone, in this video we have how on Semicircle and this side is going 7 and this two side is going 15. And then here diameter of the semicircle is asked. Okay. First of all, if you connect these two corner and let's call here alpha, opposite of the alpha and opposite of this angle have same length, right? Therefore, here, this angle is also alpha. Let's remind you, if we have a circle, and let's draw two equal chords, like this, and then let's call here theta. This arc must be equal to theta, right? And we know that if these two chords have same length, that means this arc must be equal to theta. So this angle is also theta. Okay. Let's return the question. If you notice that there is a diameter opposite of this angle, right? So here must be equal 90 degrees. Here, this angle is 90 minus alpha, right? So, if we extend this two corner, if here is alpha, that means here must be equal 90 minus alpha, right? Notice that these two angles are equal, that means we get an isosceles triangle. Let's call the corner A, B, and C. So, triangle CAB is an isosceles triangle, right? So if here is R, that means here must be equal R unit. Therefore, R minus 7 left here. Okay. And then let's call here K and T. If you notice that AKTC is a cyclic quadrilateral, right? Because all the vertices are on the circle, right? So if here is 90 minus alpha, here must be equal 90 plus alpha, right? Why? Because we know that in every cyclic quadrilateral, some of the opposite angles equal 180 degrees, right? So here must be equal 90 minus alpha. Therefore, we get an isosceles triangle again. Triangle KTB is an isosceles triangle. These two sides are equal, right? Okay. Or you can think like this. Let's connect these two corner. Notice that this angle is opposite of the diameter. So here is also 90 degrees. And these two parts are equal. That means this part must be equal to others, right? Let's remind you, if you have a right triangle and if these two parts are equal, so this part must be equal to others, right? Okay. Let's clear here. Now we can apply second theorem. So according to second theorem, R minus 7 times whole length R must be equal 15 times whole length 30, right? So if we distribute R squared minus 7R equal 450. So r squared minus 7r minus 450 equals 0. We know that 450 equals 18 times negative 25. So r plus 18 times r minus 25 equals 0. So r equals minus 18. We know that length can't be negative. Therefore, r equals 25 minutes. Okay, this was the first method. Now we will calculate value of r using second method. Let's connect these two corners. We know that these angles are alpha, right? And here is 90 degrees. Let's connect these two corners. And here is 90 degrees as well. And then cosine 2 alpha equal 7 over r, right? So we know that the expansion of cosine 2 alpha equal 1 minus 2 times sine squared alpha, right? Equal 7 over r. If you calculate sine alpha equal 15 over r, right? Therefore, if we plug in this value to the equation, 1 minus 2 times 15 over r whole squared equal 7 over r, right? So 1 minus 2 times 225 over r squared equal 7 over r. So r squared minus 450 over r squared equal 7 over r. Let's simplify the expression. So r squared minus 7r minus 450 equals 0. Notice that we get same equation. So r minus 25 times r plus 18 equals 0. That means r equal 25 units. Thanks for watching. And if you want more videos like this, please like and subscribe my channel. Take care and